seguimos con Marilyn Manson y hay muchas cosas interesantes que hablar acerca del punto de vista que tienen de la realidad y de... Listening your lyrics also again, because it's very important. You portrayed something very different in terms of like your own alternative vision of reality about what's happening, maybe influenced by some literature, influenced by some what you saw and like, I don't know, give me some names. There's some names that are coming like about like philosophy of life.
Some of the big influences on me as far as literature would be in America, Anton LaVey, the guy who wrote the Satanic Bible, Dr. Seuss, who wrote The Cat in the Hat, and
strange mix.
I guess those are two of the biggest ones, you know.
In terms of music, you tend to like go into radical, heavy stuff.
I mean, we write aggressive, heavy music. The things that have influenced the most would be things like Iggy Pop, David Bowie, Alice Cooper, Black Sabbath, a lot of the classic bands. You know.
Have you, now that you're on tour with Glenn Danzig, have you had the opportunity to share some ideas about, like, it's very interesting. That's one very interesting thing about Glenn, about, like, philosophy of life. Have you had time to share some ideas and...
We've been naked with his bus driver, but that was the closest that we've come into sharing. We hang out with Glenn sometimes. He's got a lot of important ideas too, but we haven't really got to become close. But we did get naked with his bus driver, and he likes to tie people up and things.
And what about like, there's in terms of the music, watching your live show, listening to your records, there's some strange contradiction going on because it's like, it's very, in a way, pessimistic in terms of the lyrics, but it's, I don't know, it makes you very happy in terms of, makes you as a really happy man. I mean,
right,
you're expressing
right,
what you
right,
want,
right.
But it's kind of pessimistic, it's kind of
Well, I tend to be a paradox. I think that goes back to the name Marilyn Manson. It's two things that don't make sense together. And
maybe
that's kind of what I've based my life around. I've found when you put things that don't really belong together and put them together, it works right for me, at least. A lot of people are afraid to do that. So maybe if I can share that idea with people, I might be able to accomplish something.
Is it maybe it would be pessimistic, but it produced pleasure, at least for the people who are listening.
Yeah, so that's I'm not a miserable person. I mean, I'm speaking my mind about how I feel about my life and how I feel about America.
Okay.
But I'm not a miserable person. You know, I think America's a screwed up place, but at the same time, I think that's what makes it great. You know,
Twiggy, what do you know about Latin America?
Is Eddie and the Cruisers from there?
No.
I know that they killed the chickens, don't they?
They killed the chickens?
Yeah.
Where? In Latin America?
Yeah.
They dance with the snakes, right?
They kill chickens and they pour the blood on their heads?
Well, some places.
Yeah.
Some places.
I'd like to see that.
It's a very wild place.
I'd like to see that.
Okay. And last thing, Nine Inch Nails. What do you think about the music of Nine Inch Nails?
We like it.
I like the dance with the drummer. I like the...
Okay.
He played with Nine Inch Nails once. The guitar player broke his finger and he filled in.
Okay.
And also the guitar player, before he broke his finger, came on stage at one of our shows and took off his pants and committed a felony with me on stage.
I read about that.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's
go. Nine Inch Nails.
Okay. So let's go to Nine Inch Nails. Okay. Now, guys, thank you very much.
All right.
It was great to meet you. Good album, Twiggy.
Thank you.
Take care. Aquí vamos con March of the Pigs and Headbangers.